Okay, guys, just thought I'd quickly make a video on the bird dog row in terms of the position we're looking for. Okay, so this is a core stability exercise, and the goal is to get your pelvis into a neutral position. Okay, so sometimes when you overcue an exercise, you end up going to either end of extremes of what is neutral. So to give you an example, the exercise you did last week in the yoga blocks, and the goal was to really maximally focus on it, contracting the abs. So we ask you to tuck your pelvis under. So for example, like if your pelvis is here, I would say to squeeze your backside, to draw the pelvis but in, under, as if there's your tailbone, to draw underneath. And that would increase the tension through your ab muscles. So that the goal of that we exercise was to maximally contract the abdominals. But that's not how you would move about. So you would, to engage your core, you wouldn't move about like that, because you'd end up walking about like this all day. And when you squat, if you try to do that, if you try to constantly just tuck under, you can't squat properly because you can't push your hips back. So this cue of tucking under or squeezing the glutes, it has to be taken in the context of the exercise. So for the example, it can be taken to help engage your glutes and prevent hyperextension of lumbar spine. So there's a sort of example of hyperextension here. It's going right out. I actually struggle to go into that position because I'm so used to not doing it, but some people do it almost naturally. So the cue would be, right, okay, squeeze your glutes to draw your abs in, to engage your core, to keep your pelvis neutral. But what you don't want to do is go too far and then go the other way. And then if you can't walk about like that, it's unnatural. It's very restrictive when you move. And actually, by trying to correct maybe a bit of back pain with hyperextension, by trying to correct it by focusing on the glutes and squeezing in, you can end up exacerbating the problem if you then just focus on that too much and then walk about. But that's all the time, try and squat like that. If you squat like that, it's actually probably just going to cause back pain and potentially knee pain because your knees travel forward, because there's no room for your hips to go. So the pelvis moves naturally, and you don't want to restrict it. When it's not incorrect for it to move out the way. You don't want it hyperextended, but it will extend. There's a difference between extension and hyperextension. And so it's about finding the sweet spot and for the particular exercise you're doing. So when you walk about, when you run, you want to be in that sort of neutral position. You don't want to be that way or that way. You just want to be neutral. But there's exercises and cues you can use to help mitigate either end of the extremes. But the danger is you over-cue and overthink that one cue, and then it ends up all over the place again. Okay, so basically, what we're looking for is, with that in mind, okay, to try and get the position, this leg should be straight. That foot can be pointed if you want, but it's probably better just keeping it, pulling your toes up, get your ankle working a wee bit. And then from there, this is the area we're concentrating on. So we don't want it to, you don't want to tuck under, because if you do, you're overdoing the ab engagement and you end up losing the position at the shoulders. But equally, you don't want to go the opposite way. I struggle to go the opposite way, but you don't want to go the opposite way and not engage at all. So you just want to find your sweet spot whereby everything's pretty stable. You should feel a sort of engagement through the core. When you take the kettlebell, the engagement will probably increase a little bit. And you just need to make sure that as you tire, because naturally as you tire, you start to hyperextend. So you need to just be aware of that so that you're holding the position in neutral the whole time. Okay. So that's what we're looking for in this. Is we're just going to hold the kettlebell for as long as you can. Okay, so just please bear that in mind, especially in squats. Okay, so people sometimes have, I think it's usually because of Instagram and all that, they have this habit of when you at the top, you squeeze through and you push through the hips as if it's going to work their bum muscles better, but it doesn't. Basically. it can help, but don't get me wrong, the concept of squeezing the glutes is a good thing to think about in order to keep the neutral spine at the top, but you don't want to push through. It's an inefficient, very, very unathletic concept that. You would never do that when it comes to sprinting, running, jumping, and it's in my opinion, it's actually probably bad form as opposed to good form. So just hold it neutral, okay? If you're not getting the glute engagement that you feel you should be getting from a squat, then it's not going to come from just doing that. It's going to come from improving the movement, maybe progressively overloading the movement, or isolating the muscle with different exercises. Anyway, sorry, end up randomly rambling a bit there.